And here we are. What's up, everyone? He's 7 away from the money, so we got to be a bit careful here with the ace-9 suited. It's definitely important to consider what we want to do here that close to the money. Yeah, I'm just going to call. We're going to check it back here. Just because we're 7 off the money, we don't really want to necessarily have to get it in on the flop if somebody check jams into me. Let's see a turn first. Alright, king, 8, diamond. Vamos. Like, I just don't want to bluff here, as I said. Just take away equity and hit. We hit both. So what's the maximum an ace will always call? That's the sizing we want to bet here. The maximum sizing that will always get called by an ace is the correct bet sizing here. And I think that sizing is like 13,000. Nice. Alright. Wait, is there any way we are not icing this given that we are on a stone bubble? This might actually be a fold on a stone bubble. Hmm. Two guys behind covers as well. I don't think that makes it into the call. Could be wrong about that, by the way. I'm not an expert on bubble play. I would always call this if this was not the stone bubble. But the combination of his jam range supposed to be being tighter and us being covered by the two guys behind. Even though, like, he needs to win against them and I lose. I don't know. Because quite often you have a message from somebody where, like, ah, it's kind of weird, what the fuck. But you never bother to ban him or anything. And he talks shit. See ya. That's unfortunate. Time to the jack. Hit the road, jack. So I don't have to hit the road, jack. No. Just not something that where I'm too excited, you know? It hurts to lose 1k in one tournament online with 100% of myself. Played like the 5kW coupe, stuff like that, but just the daily 1ks and shit are very far away still, I think. Let's hold here. Nice, that's good. Not for me. He hates it, yeah. I really dislike it. I'm gonna call the flop here, king high. It's good pretty often. He bets turn again, I will call again. We have two overcards to the board, so we can just be good with that. And plenty of draws. That was a great river. Very underbluffed river, expecting a high amount of, like, a check very often here. Come on, check it, dude. And that's why you call twice with king high, guys. Beautiful. I don't think he should be bluffing queen high. I think that's just, like, showdown value. Nice pot there. It's one of these board textures where when I bet, I'm like, we never get a fold here. Why did you bet? And then you always get a fold for some reason. I don't know. Just feels like we shouldn't get folds there too often. I don't know. How do you get started with PO solver? I got Race Edge and Isomaster 2, and I feel like PO is the next step for getting more control with all the post-flop stuff. I just sat down, fired up the program, watched a bunch of YouTube videos, and tried shit out. Made a lot of mistakes. If you want to get started with PO, I would like recommend getting the new upswing course first, or like get it at the same time, because it will save you so much fucking time with PO. Like, he explains very well how to use PO, which things you have to pay attention to, like how to properly set it up, which sizings, why these sizes are important. Very, very important. And then like the combination of the upswing course, like when Nikki P explains everything, and then some YouTube videos will give you a good idea how to use PO. But I only started using some extra like tools that PO has after watching some videos in Upswing, because I didn't find YouTube videos about them. And Nick Petrangelo actually uses them in almost every video and goes over it and explains, okay, this is why what we should be doing, let's look why, and then he goes over it, so it's great. What do you think about this king queen spot? Feels like we should ISO, eh? Let's go. We are now. Oh shit, guys, come on, let's get there. Oh, we need a king. Oh, that's a good flop. Ace 9. Come on, ace 9. Oh, fuck yeah. Sponsored fucking bro. Holy shit, these runs on natural 8 lately, man. You know, team bro, Team fucking bro. Alright, let's win the main again. I'm gonna mix and check raise with this one. How about that one? Natural 8, bro. Natural 8, bro. So he's gonna have some flushes. I actually don't know what we should be doing here. I mean, we're just going for it, I guess. Fucking go golden rocket. It's really tough, man. We're not folding here if he does anything. Please don't have the flush here. Just have ace 8 of diamonds. Fuck, natural 18, bro. What is that? Not rigged for me, actually. Got any beta on Don's GTO app? Nope. I would assume we do something down the road where... I mean, I haven't talked with him much about him. I haven't talked with Dom in a while anyhow. I mean, we chat occasionally, like a little bit random stuff, but... I haven't seen him, like, in a year or something. Good luck, easy ISO was the button. Jam here's the King Jack suited. We ahead, can we hold? Hold. No, come on, king. Damn it. Damn it, damn it, damn it. Good luck, 9-8 suited. There it is. Alright, now it's my turn to get there with 8-9 of diamonds. Let's do it. Alright, this is kind of similar. Come on. Come on. Yes, baby. 8-9 of diamonds. It's a easy game. Pocket nines is very likely to go in. Good luck, guys. Come on. Here, 10-8 of spades. Alright, fade that fucking ace. And the check. Nice. Let's go. The battle is real on this one. Let's call. Okay. Fuck you, I won't do what you tell me. Fuck you. Alright. So on the final table, we are 6th in chips. Ugh, if you get moved into the big blind on the FT, that sucks as well. What the fuck is going on right now? I don't like this. Hey, we get moved to under the gun. It's a little bit better, I guess. And now we get moved to the small blind. Alright, could be worse. Let's give them the good game. And let's fucking win this shit, because it's been a rough day. And it's time for a bink. Ooh, baby. And do something. Thank you. Ooh, this is a good flop for some check jamming. Come on, hold it. On the FT, please. Oh no. Hold. Hold! Yes! Nice. Nice, nice. Give me the day save on natural 8, please. Quickly readjusting the payouts. And now we get into it. So what happens on natural 8 is once you reach the final table, timings are gone. Everybody just gets a personal shot clock. This shot clock is based on like a normal time. I think it's like 10 minutes. And then plus the additional time that you had in your time bank before that. So, you know, somebody that stalls a lot beforehand has a bit of a shorter time bank on the final table. What happens now is for every decision, every tank you do, your time bank ticks down. And if you come, if it drops to zero, you will have... 5 seconds per decision. The reason they did a shot clock like this is just to speed up the play on the final table, right? You often have people tanking and everything is very slow on final tables usually. And this really speeds up the play on the final table a lot because everybody's inclined to preserve their time bank by playing faster. And yeah, that's what this shot clock does. And even though I was opposed to it in the beginning, Now I'm a fan as well. Because the final tables are way faster on that trade than anywhere else. Not because of the structure, but because of the faster play. There's also a big edge to be had against notorious tankers. Let's check it back here. You see, like, usually you tank for like 7 seconds here. I tank for like a second now and checked. Now he bets turn. I really want to call this once. Good river. Very underbluffed now. Beautiful, guys. Beautiful. Tail position is not amazing with the big stacks to my left, so maybe this is too out of line. But like, we would definitely open check 9 suited here, so check 8 suited is kind of borderline. I think we want to check this back and then go for some delayed betting. It's good. If it's like large, we're only calling. This we are raising. It's not happening. Those two small sizings, we gotta raise. Well, that's pretty unfortunate. King queen for a ladder here. That would be nice. There we go. As I said, like, Chiron, you cannot get it for... It would take months until they have more deposit options. Sadly. What we can do is trade money. You send me some money on stars, I send you some on natural 8. But that's about it. Right now, it's just a stupid situation. Can't wait for summer to come here as well. It's gonna be really nice. Alright, we obviously go for another value bet on the turn. And then we decide if we want to go for it on the river again. Ugh. Why does my life suck so much? What is that? It's just so dumb, man. Like, oh, people that jack jam the turn here. The problem is it doesn't make sense to do it with the value. But what would you bluff here, you know? Like, you just don't just jack call the flop with queen jack of diamonds and raise it here, or like ace four of diamonds. It's just, people are just not doing that. They're just not doing it, you know? Like, occasionally you see it, but like, we cannot just go with that, you know? We cannot just go with that occasional. I'm Mr. Overfold Lero on these spots, and I think that's correct. Come on, we need to get one letter. Daily four figure score. What was the overlay in the 88 main? 35 runners. Oh shit, that could be here. Bryson to call a lot here. Doesn't have it. Now he needs to figure out. Like, he has complete chunk here. Otherwise, like, ace queen is a snap with that those pot outs. Thanks, Holder. I live in Austria. Damn. Alright, we all in. Good luck, guys. Bülero. 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 I need the daily four figure score. Don't do it to me. Don't do it to me. Oh shit, guys, come on. Wow, a lot of equity. Come on, king, queen. Hi. Oh, hi. Yes, 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 yes. Oh, that sound though. Yeah. Staying alive. We have an easy card with the king, it's suited, right? I mean, yeah. Good luck. Alright, 40% equity, number 2. Let's do it. It's a good start. Can we fade it? Team pro, question mark? Team fucking pro! Natural 8, number 2 on the river. Let's get it, guys. The four-figure score. The daily four-figure score. The daily fucking four-figure score. There it is. Ah. Easy game. But we folded the king-jack earlier. You know, that's the type of shit that's keeps you alive. Gonna give him a raise against a small bet here. I think most people are usually sizing it up when they have a straight here or a jack. So we're gonna charge queen 10, 9, 10, ace 4 of hearts. I don't think we see a lot of heroes here, that's the reason I'm checking back. Yeah, I think that's a good amount of value from king 9. I didn't really see that calling the river if I bet big there. Wow, this is actually fucked. Holy shit, this is fucked. Nah, it's fine. We can just 3-bet call. I assume it's not that much of a consideration given given how small the ladders are coming up. So we can just happily 3-bet call this, yeah. At first I was worried because it's usually ICM suicide to 3-bet call in a spot like this. But I think here it's totally fine because... I mean, if you look at the payouts, it's going to be $200, $300 and then shit kicks off. So if you bust out here in 5th, because... you know, something happens, it's all right. Like, we don't have to worry that much about it. Always pay attention to the letters, guys, and not just think, oh, ICM pressure overall, we five-handed on the final table with multiple runners, but actually look at the payouts and go from there. And looking at these payouts here, I think it clearly suggests that we should be just getting this one in. As I said, $200 ladder, $400 ladder, and 1200 and 2.2. So it's still pretty top heavy. And this is the thing we want to focus on. Yeah. At first I was like, okay, what the fuck, this is weird, but very easy spot. So hope these guys find the 3-bet jam. Come on. Pocket deuces. Okay. I mean, if there's any issue with the stream, check your end first, because if there's an issue on my end, there's going to be multiple people spamming it in Twitch chat. Oh, we get check raise for small sizing on the flop. We're going to continue with a call or a raise. I think call is the play. Okay. 6 not my favorite turn. 7-5 gets there. But we're obviously still calling. The good thing is here he doesn't have pocket 8s and he might not even have pocket 4s because the jam's pre-flop. We're definitely betting turn now. Just a check. I think third pot makes a lot of sense this deep. If he jams now, we puke. We lose to ace-queen. Jams pre-flop a lot. 30 blinds deep. I think we gotta jam this. I don't really see how he would check a set on a turn or two pair. So I'm gonna value jam this because I don't think he would raise ace-8 on the flop or ace-6 too often at least. So he finds a hero here with the queen-jack. Monka S. Please don't make me kill the stream. He folds. Good pot for us though. I'm happy with the value jam, as I said, I don't think he has a lot of good hands here. Almost in a chip lead now, guys. The 88 main event, can we ship it again? I already won it once this month, on a Sunday. Would be fucking amazing. Oh shit, come on. There it is. Ooh, queens was king-queen suited. Ambitious 3-bet call there. SD value, showdown value. Stacked. Oh, nasty. We're down to 4. Gonna call this. If he jams. Good luck. Ooh, 3 and K in the middle. That's sadly as ace-4. Still have obviously good equity, but lots of hands that we dominate. Just need to fade a queen. Nice. Running good. Running good, guys. Not bad. Let's raise call the ace-10. Good luck. Huge pot. Oh my god, he's dominated. Can we hold for the heads up? I saw the 9 and was like, no. Faded. Let's fucking go, guys, for the heads up. Let's fucking go. Oh shit. Let's fucking go! What the fuck? What the fuck? What the fuck? No way, we just win it because he jams like 80 bigs in there. That's why you don't take deals, people. What in the world? We just win the tournament. Let's go. How is this life real, man? Oh my god. No way, no way. We win 5,300 bucks, guys. In the natural 8 main, just shipping it again for the second time this month. Oh my god, let's do it. What a time to be alive.